What's up, guys? Check it out. I get so many questions about my visor and all of the blinders and stuff on my visor. So I wanted to tackle that and let you guys know what the heck I got going on with the helmet in today's video.
Goldstar TV.
Today is actually the Racer's Banquet. I just happened to stop by the shop for a couple minutes. Wanted to quick make this video for you guys. So this is like the one time a year that I'm wearing the diamonds. And oh my gosh. Look at those dry hands, it's disgusting. I'm wearing the diamonds today, so don't think that I'm like, we're going to the Racer's Banquet after this, so no judging. So when it comes to blinders on your visor or your helmet for bracket racing, I think there's like three main reasons why you would want to have blinders. The first one would be like for the bottom bulb racer, which is not me, but I see a lot of bottom bulb racers using blinders to like block out the top two bulbs, or maybe to block out the other side of the tree. And so I see a lot of people doing that. If I was a bottom bulb racer, I would probably try that. I would probably try something like that. But the one thing that I would be concerned about is actually the glow of the ambers at nighttime would probably bleed around that blinder, and it probably really wouldn't be effective at nighttime. So that'd be one thing that I would be concerned about. I've actually seen other people online that actually have like amber bulbs inside of their cockpit of their car or something to basically blind that amber glow at nighttime. I don't know if that works or not. They're basically just adding a lot of amber glow around them to try and allow them to use a blinder and not have the other bulbs light leak around that blinder. But like I said, I've never tried that before. I'm just trying to give you guys ideas on this channel on things that I have seen other people do. I don't know how effective that is, but for bottom bulb racing, I can definitely see the value. If I was a bottom bulb racer, I would probably try that out so that I would just block out everything except the bottom bulb that I need to react to. The other thing that I hear people use the blinders on the side of their helmet, which I don't know if you guys can see that very well. Take this thing off here. Let's get a look at it. All right, so the other thing that I see people doing with like the blinders on the side of their helmet would be for people who are actually looking at the tree through their visor. The side blinders are a lot of times just used to block your peripheral vision. If you have like a really good peripheral vision, you probably get distracted very easily. And I can definitely see the value in that. That's definitely something that I'm gonna look into trying a little bit more next year, is actually having this visor in the down position when I'm reacting to the tree. I mean, you're a lot more laser focused on what's going on when you have these blinders and you're just kind of like looking right where you need to look. You're not seeing what's going on in the other lane. You're not seeing what the guy running the tree is doing. You're not seeing what people in the stands are doing. You're not seeing some flag waving in the wind. You're not seeing some other headlights coming down the return road or something like that. There's a lot of distractions on the starting line. So the blinders on the side could actually help you out with that, especially blocking out your peripheral vision. The third thing for the side blinders on the helmet would be what I actually have them on there for. So I actually have four blinders taped off on my helmet. I don't know how well you guys can see that, but I'm basically just looking through a rectangle. That's kind of what it looks like going down the track for me. Now the reason for these blinders is a little bit different. The top and the bottom one are for sun purposes. So of course this blinder here is for when I'm going down the track with the visor down. I don't want the sun in my eyes. That's the whole purpose for that. That one's pretty obvious. This bottom one is for when the visor is in the up position and I'm on the starting line, because I react to the tree with the visor open currently. I'm thinking about trying that a little bit different next year, but I react to the tree with the visor open, so I can actually adjust this to block out the sun on the starting line. It's very valuable to have this bottom section taped off so you can just kind of adjust that and block that sun out on the starting line. So that's what the top and the bottom two blinders are for. When it comes to the side blinders, what I use them for is actually at the finish line. So what I prefer to do is have these side blinders on here. So I just look in through a rectangle, and what it helps me to do is turn my head 90 degrees at the finish line. It helps square me up with the competition. I don't wanna be looking at the competition with my peripheral vision. I wanna make sure I'm squared up. I got a clear line of what I'm looking at on the other car. It really helps me to judge a finish line if I know I'm looking straight over at them. So if I have these blinders on here, it forces me to turn my head all the way to actually see them. So it's really helped me at the finish line, is actually driving the finish line with these side blinders on. If you're looking for a little bit more professional looking option other than just using like electrical tape all over your visor, there are other options out there. I know that Jegs and probably Summit makes like a mask that you actually stick to the outside of your visor. It's cut out really nice and it looks really nice. You could do something like that. I've also seen people have actual like flip up like adjustable side blinders that they put on their helmet and that they actually can adjust, you know, where they are. I feel like that could maybe get in the way a little bit, especially if you're really moving your head around in the cockpit, it's probably gonna hit that on stuff. But I have a GoPro strapped to my helmet all the time and it never seems to hit anything. So there is other options out there, but I just prefer to use the electrical tape method. Blocks everything out, get yourself some good sun blocks in there, and then also have those side blinders. I use it at the finish line, but a lot of people use that for peripheral vision blocking on the starting line. So there you have it, guys. Just a few quick reasons why you would have blinders on your helmet in a bracket racing situation. Let me know in the comments down below if you guys use blinders on your helmet. What is the reason you have those blinders and how has it affected your performance? I'd love to have a conversation down in the comment section below. Be sure to hit the like button if you like this video. Subscribe if you're new here. Turn on the bell for notifications. It would really mean a lot to me, you guys. Thank you so much for the support. I'll catch you all in the next one. Later.